excited. All right, guys. So this event was freaking amazing. You know, obviously we have our corporate events, which are out of this world, and they're, you know, even more important, but I'm a huge believer in other personal development. And this event that we went to, it basically, it combines everybody in all network marketing companies, and they don't say who they're with, things like that. So it stays very generalized and neutral for everybody. So you can just get tips from the top from everybody. So this was amazing hearing from them. And yeah, if anyone else wants to jump off here and there, because a couple of the girls that were there aren't able to get on. But anyway, so they take all these different people, and it was absolutely amazing hearing these people, because it just confirmed to me that, like, we're in the best business in the universe, and we are still so freaking small. I was talking to Katie, and I was kind of explaining this a little bit. I'll just kind of give you guys a couple little things first, and then I will start with the other girls, because I could talk for 5 hours about this. So I'll let them kind of give their couple tips, and then I'll jump in as we go. But there was a few people. So the first person, it was amazing, you guys. These people from the other companies, they were literally saying that they were in there for 30, 40 years. Some of them were, you know, in there like 27, and their company had been created when they were like 4 years old. So, you know, they were like, people told me that I didn't get in at the right time. I, you know, started too late. My company had already reached its growth. And then they jumped into their company when it was 20, you know, 2 years old, and they raced to the top, because there is so much room to grow in every single company still, honestly. And if you guys didn't know, It Works is only like 17 years old, I believe. We're freaking babies. Like, after hearing these people talk, we are like little babies in comparison. We have not even touched anything, and there is so much room to grow. You know, we are not even in all of these countries that people are in yet, and we are slowly opening up. And it just confirmed to me that I am where I should be, and that you guys are where you should be, because we're going to explode. Like, I'm planting so many seeds now for 2017, because, you know, we look at Joel and Stephanie, which, if you guys didn't know, they're the number one income earners in this, in our company. And basically it's $100,000 a month for 6 consecutive months is Black Diamond. Okay. That is the highest rank, I guess, in our company. And only 3 people have ever achieved it. And, you know, Joel and Stephanie probably make 200 or so a month, which is absolutely amazing. But these people in these other companies that have been in there for, you know, 3, 5, 10, 20, 30, 40 years are just like way past that. And, you know, sometimes we're in our own little bubble, and we like compare ourselves to things and to people, and we're just like, I missed my chance. But you guys, like, we haven't even done anything. Like, we literally have not even done anything. And I don't know about you guys, but I'm going to be a part of it, and I'm going to do more. And, you know, this year, so last year on my dream board, it was $30,000 a month. That was my year goal. Okay. So then I hit it, and then I put $50,000 a month on my dream board. And, I didn't hit it this year yet, but, you know, I was going to put that same 50,000 on my new dream board for 2017, because honestly, even that to me was scary. I was like, I am not Black Diamond material. I'm like, I can't do $100,000 a month yet. But after going to this, it's just like, there is so much that we can do just ourselves. Like, you don't have to be different. You don't have to be special. You just have to work. That's it. Period. End of story. Work. And the rest will come. You don't have to feel like you have to be inspiring or this leader, whatever. You need personal development and work. And so for me, I put $70,000 for my next goal, and I will hit it by the end of next year. And so I raised that. I raised that shiz, and I was like, ah, that's scary. But that was another thing. One of the guys was saying, like, if your goals seem too attainable, they're not big enough. Like, they're not big enough. They need to be bigger. They need to be like, what the crap? Because guess what? That's how you're going to put them in your path. That's how you're going to make them happen when you dream bigger. And really quick, before I let anyone else go, one of the examples he gave was that he never, ever, ever had any business walking on the red carpet. He wasn't an actor. He didn't do anything like that. The only people that actually get to do that are the actresses that have like made Grammys, things like that. So long story short, he put it on a dream board like 20 years ago and randomly just put it on there. And because of a series of events, I won't go into all of it, but because of a series of events that it was like a hop, skip, a jump, a marathon, a this, a that, this random person that he met that connected him to this person. And, you know, there was something that was going to happen where he was like, yes, we're going to be able to be guests there. And, you know, we're going to be able to at least be at the Grammys. We won't be able to walk the red carpet, but we'll at least be able to be at the Grammys. And he, it didn't pan out. It didn't work out. And, you know, that's like with us. Sometimes we don't hit our goals that are right in front of us. And you can do two things. You can be like, you know what? That's okay. That wasn't the right path for my goals. Or what a lot of us do is, you know, we're like, oh, it's never going to happen. Like, I know you guys have seen that picture where it's like, you know, the person that's slow and steady and they're doing it and they're doing it. And then it's coming out of the ground. And then the other person's like, it's coming out of the ground faster. And they're like, oh, this doesn't work. And then it goes back down. It's kind of like that. And, you know, long story short, he ended up being able to walk the Grammys because he was a stand-in for one of the actors instead of, you know, getting tickets or buying tickets or anything like that. And that's the only way he was able to do it. So it's just kind of crazy to me. And that's when I was like, all right, you know, you guys know I'm so big into dream boards and belief, but that's when I was like, all right, I gotta do bigger. I gotta be bigger because also like, I need to be the example for you guys. Like if I'm like, oh yeah, I can hit that stuff on my dream board. Like no problem, you know, then what is that saying? Like for you guys, like we all need to dream bigger together. Okay. So, and I'm making a new dream board tonight. I'm switching some of my stuff. I'm so excited. Okay. So let me see. I'm just going to go through like the top from the people that I see and the ones that I know came. And then we'll just go from there. Okay, so Lasagna. Hi. You look all fancy. And if you guys don't know Lasagna, she is just, I think so highly of her. She's just an angel. And just so you guys know, like, you show up, you go up. Like, you got to show up for yourself. You got to show up for your team. And that doesn't just mean show up to places. That means show up by signing distributors, signing customers. Like, that's who you'll attract. So you got to be that person that you want on your team. But anyways, Lasagna, is there a couple things that stood out to you, something that someone said, maybe a tip, or just what do you want to share?
Well, so that I don't take away from everyone, because I could go like the Energizer Bunny right now. I still feel like I'm drunk from this past weekend. But anyway, one of the things that I really got that I took away is the fact that you can change your mood or your disposition like that. When I say like that, I mean like literally like in a moment. And I saw it and it was real. The feeling of how that happened was real. It wasn't something that was like, oh, everybody miss Penny Annie. Like people really felt the difference and the change. And for me, that's one of the things that's going to help me every day. And the next day I did it. I was like, okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Like I said, that's two different people, but I did it. And I got up and I was like, okay, time to start the day. Slept horrible and everything. But when I got up, I was like, it's time to start the day. So like I said, that in itself was so vital to me knowing I'm still new in this business, but it's time to rock and roll. It's time to get it going. And that's all there is. So can't stop, won't stop. And that's what I'm doing in December. So long way to the top. And I hope everybody's going to come with me. If not, you don't want me to drag you. So I suggest you come on.
Okay, so I'm going to kind of elaborate on what she said just a little bit. So the part that she's talking about, it's two different things, but one of them is Tony Robbins. You guys, like, motion creates emotion. And the thing is like, if you are physically in a sad or an upset state, you have to physically move. Like, imagine, he had us kind of do some exercises. Like, imagine if you have, I think it's like 3 to 5 seconds to make a first impression. That's it. That's all you get. When you meet someone, when they, you know, see you, when you maybe do a video, whatever, you have 3 to 5 seconds. That's it. And he had us kind of, do like some examples, like when you're meeting somebody, you know, like meet them as if you're shy, meet them as if they intimidate you. Meet them as if you're confident. And it was all these different things. And it was a completely different mannerism with every single person. And the last one was amazing. Like, okay, well, the second to last one, it was like, you know, meet them as if, you know, you're happy to see them. Like, you're confident and you're like, hey, I'm Chrissy. How are you? But then the last one was like, meet them as if you were their long lost, like, friend. Like, you haven't seen them in ages. Like, we all know we've done that before. You see someone and you just like book it to them and you're like, oh my gosh. And imagine if every time you talk to somebody or you met someone or even you were on the phone with them or you were doing a video or, you know, you met them at Starbucks. Imagine if you talked to everybody like that. Do you think they could stay away? No, they could not stay away. They'd be like, you're the happiest person I know. I need to be your friend. I need to be around you. And honestly, that's kind of like how I feel with Lasagna. Like, if you ever meet her, you're just like, can I hang out with you? Because you are just fun, you know? And you guys, like, we have to be that. Like, why would anybody join your business if you look like you're scared to talk to them? Why would anyone want to sell your product if you're shy and look like, like I'm scared, you know, like I'm not confident. Like, you need to put out what you want to attract. And honestly, like, part of what she was saying too is Tony Robbins talks a lot about, like, you know, if you're not giving, you'll never be fulfilled. Like, that's a huge part, you know, because in our business, it is a blessing and it is a curse because we have no cap on our income. So have any of you guys ever hit a promotion and you work so freaking hard for it and then you get it and you're like, woo! Okay, what now? Next. Like, next thing, you know? And that's the thing, like, that will happen to your business and you have got to learn how to be happy and excited and enjoy the ride. Like, I hit ambassador and, you know, I had so much excitement and happiness. Like, I was like, I love this. I blah, blah, blah. Like, I'm pushing for it. I'm, you know, and then I hit it and I'm like, yes. And then I got my 2 minutes of It Works fame. And then I was like, okay, what's next? 2.0 spot, you know, and you're never really fulfilled unless you're focusing on the other people in your business and around that. Because what are you going to do when you're making $100,000 a month? Like, what are you going to do? Do you think you're going to be happy when you're making $100,000 a month? Then it's going to be $200,000 a month to make you happy. And he used the example of Robin Williams. You know, like, he has been to, I don't even know how many continents. I didn't write that down, but he has been to so many continents. And every single time he goes there, he asks the same question. Like, who knows and loves him. Like, doesn't like him, who loves him. And everybody puts their hand up from all around the world. And he says, you know, and he killed himself. He wanted to, you know, earn a Grammy. He did it. He wanted to do it for, you know, not for a dramatic film instead of, you know, his normal self of making people laugh. He did it. He wanted a happy family, wife, kids. He did it. He wanted to do this. He did it. And he freaking killed himself. Why? Because he was not happy with himself. Period. End of story. And like, if there's nothing else that I teach you guys, it's to just be happy and enjoy the ride. Because imagine if every single one of you guys became Ambassador Diamonds, like tomorrow, okay? Then you're still going to be in this exact same thing, like, okay, what's next? What's next? Keep going, you know, and you're always just waiting for the next thing. And I know you guys have heard examples of people doing that. And it's not fun. It's not good. And that's why I always say, like, this business is a roller coaster. It's a roller coaster and you have to enjoy it. I love roller coasters. So I'm just going to enjoy the ride, the ups and the downs. You have to realize it's just a business and there's going to be ups and downs. It would be impossible to always go up. You know, like at church they say, like, because people always say, well, you know, if God really loved us that much, why would he give us pain? But if we didn't know pain, we would never know happiness. It's the same exact thing. So we have to learn to enjoy. If somebody says no, like, that's okay. This business isn't for you. That's okay. You know, and you move on. And honestly, that always means like, just not yet. But you just got to learn it and enjoy it. And, you know, I'm going to kind of give an example of myself and kind of be vulnerable for just a minute, you know, because you guys see these leaders, whether it be me or Stacy or Katie, or, you know, there's even leaders on this team. It doesn't matter your rank, but it, you know, how you act, what you do, your actions, and even other people in the company. And we all go through the same things, you know, like last week for like 2.5 days. And I give that time frame to show you that, like, it's as easy to get out of it as this. That's it. I was like, I suck. I was like literally depressed for like 2 days. Like, you guys know me, like, my energy level is like up here. And that is honestly what grows my business. It allows me to talk to people. It's my energy level. And, you know, just keeping that excitement, that happiness. And I like barely talked for like 2.5 days. And Aaron's like, what is wrong with you? And I'm like, I'm just in my own head. Like, I don't even want to talk about it, you know? And for me, you know, I want you guys to come and talk to me if you ever feel like that. But for me, I'm like, I don't really have anyone to talk to. It's my husband. I'm not going to go to my downline. Like, we all know you can't do that. That's not what you're supposed to do. And I don't exactly have an upline that is, I hate to say, that's at where I'm at, but, you know, I want a mentor. I want someone to be able to pull me out of it. But guess what? That's me. Who can pull you out of it? You. And I already know that because it's happened before. So I was like, what the heck? Like, this is how I felt. And I'm sure you guys have felt like this before. I felt like I really want to cuss, but I don't. I felt like I was half-aying everything. Like, my business, I was giving 50%. I'm still signing people, but you know when you're working your business, like, boom, and then when you're just like, boom, like signing people, but it's like, meh, I'm here, I'm there. And I felt like, and I'm sure you guys could get it, because on last week's training, I was like, I wasn't there. I wasn't myself. And I just felt like I wasn't giving. And it's funny because Katie and I were talking about this, and I'm like, Katie, get out of your own head, blah, blah, blah. But guess what? At that exact same time I was talking to her about it, pulling her out of it, that's exactly how I felt. And obviously I didn't say that at the time, but I was like, my kids, like, I feel like I'm not giving them 100%. I'm not giving my business 100%. My house is a freaking mess. If you guys see any of my selfies, my bedroom's got clothes everywhere. I'm like, I can't get it together. I clean one room and everything else is a mess. And, you know, like, do I clean my room or play with my kids? Do I work my business or, you know, do this or do that? And I just felt like I wasn't giving anything 100%, and I just felt overwhelmed. And, you know, there was something that I was missing. And it was honestly, I was focusing on me. I was super selfish because I was like, why am I not motivated? Why can't I get my crap together? I've been doing this for 4 years. Like, why can't I like focus? Why can't I get, you know, my schedule in line? Like, what's wrong with me? But that was the problem because I was focusing on me. I wasn't focusing on you guys. I wasn't focusing on my potentials. I was focusing on me. I was thinking about me. And that's when I decided that we needed to do something like bigger for Gives Back. And I was like, Mom, I want to do something. I want it to be really big. Help me out, because she's got all the connections and whatever. And that's when we set up the thing to do for the Give Back. And after that, I was like, okay, that's exactly what I needed. And obviously this event helped, but I was, you know, out of it like the day before, because we set up this to give back. And I was like, that's what it is. Like, I needed that contribution because I needed to appreciate what I have, but also be, you know, motivated to get more. Because guess what? If you get more, you can give more. And the more people I help, the faster I'll get to $100,000 a month. Like, period, end of story. And that's why you just have to enjoy that ride. Like, you have to appreciate it and you have to focus on other people. If you feel like you're in a slump, it's because you're focusing on you too much. You know, like, you need to do personal development. You need to grow yourself as a person, as a leader, as a business owner. But you need to do that and put it right back into your potentials, right back into your team, right back into whatever cause you like. You know, like, sometimes we feel like we need to do this big, huge thing, but honestly, we just need to do a little bit, and that little bit will give us, you know, the opportunity to do more and more and more and more. So that's honestly, like, I was thinking like, okay, I need to do this, I need to do that. But really, it was just like, focus on other people. And then I was like, you know what, like, I can do this. And I made a list and I did my stuff and then I play with my kids and I felt all better. So, and I know that it happens with all of us. And so that's why I just kind of wanted to be honest with you guys. And at the event too, when Tony Robbins was talking, the part that Lasagna is also talking about is like, you have to physically move. You have to physically move. Like, that's why I love music so much. Because if you just listen to your favorite song, whatever, and as goofy as it seems, you're like, I look crazy right now, like, just jump. Actually, all of our shins were sore because we were jumping around so much. But guess what? When you do that, like, all you have to do is jump and scream and dance to music, and you're like, I'm the happiest person in the universe. It's literally because you are physically moving your body and you're getting that motion in place. So, like, if you're having a bad day, if you're feeling slumpy in your business or you're feeling unmotivated, whatever, like, you need to physically do something. Like, I'm not, because if people are like, I'm not going to the gym, you don't have to go to the gym. Just put on your favorite song and start jumping around and be like, whoa, like, just pump yourself up, you know, like those crazy videos, like that little girl who's like, you're awesome, you're special, you're amazing, you know, in the mirror. Do that, because that's what's going to do freaking amazing things for you. But anyways, like I said, I could talk all day long, just like Lasagna. Okay, so I'll move on. Okay, so Stacey.
Hello.
Hello, Stacey. All right, your turn.
Okay, so there are so many things that obviously helped me, but I will only talk about one. The main thing that I just absolutely loved was, you know, and it's so simple, but Mel Robbins, she's, you know, the girl, she's a girl network marketer, like, really successful. And she asked us, you know, how long does it take to change our life? And, you know, some people are like 10 years, I don't know, 3 years, a year with hard work. And she's like, it literally takes 5 seconds. She's like, it's just a moment in time where you decide one way or the other, and that can change your life. And that really stuck with me because for like the business. So I'll just give you an example. During the break, I went to go grab some food, and I'm in line, and there's like a huge line, and, you know, I'm like super pumped up, and the girl taking my order, she's like my age, she's super cute, like super energetic, And I just, and usually I get scared. I get really scared when, especially when there's a line behind me. And I already told my team this, so if you're listening, sorry. But there, if there's like a line or something, I probably wouldn't do it. Like that's just, I've just been scared to do it. But I thought of the 5-second rule is what it is. And she's like, just count down from 5 and just decide that you're going to do it. So I did that. And I said, hey, girl, have you ever heard of It Works? And she was like, At Works? And I'm like, no, It Works, you know, like the body wrap. And she was like, no, I've never heard of it. And I was like, oh, my gosh, girl, I've got to tell you about it. Do you have Facebook? Can I add you on Facebook? And she was like, yeah. And so she wrote down her name on my receipt. And she's like, you know what? If I can't, you might not be able to find me. It's hard to find me. So what's your name? And I'm like, you know what? What's your number? And I'll text you my name. So I got her number and I texted the name and she added me on Facebook. And she has like 5,000 friends, like super amazing. So gorgeous. She's like played basketball in college and you know, and we can relate that way because I played basketball in college and all sorts of things. And so I was just like, oh my gosh, you know, if I hadn't have done that, she would have heard from it from somebody else and she would have been a rock star in somebody else's team because I know that she's going to join my team. And so that just really, really stuck to me. And ever since then, 5-second rule is just what I'm going to live by because it really does just take 5 seconds to change your life, to make a decision right then and there. So, you know, and even after 5 seconds, they kept saying your mind will play tricks on you. You know, you'll start to think and then you'll overthink and then you'll never do it and you'll regret not doing it. And, you know, that goes with anything, messaging people, just posting on Facebook, adding random friends or blitzing. So that's something that I just loved.
You know, it's so funny. So in the beginning of the event, they said, if anything, you know, if we're doing our job, you're going to take home one thing that you remember and you apply and it changes your business. And mine was that same thing. I told Aaron about it. He's like, what? Like he didn't even hear it. Whereas me, that was the only thing I heard. Like, that's like the one thing I was like, yes, because the way she explained it, just like you said, like after 5 seconds, we're like, okay. And this is, I'll give my example. Normally I'm like, okay, I'm going to talk to this girl on my chicken list. I'm going to message her. I'm going to send her this awesome voice message, all pumped up, whatever. And then I'm like, okay, the kids are crying. I'm going to do it in 5 minutes. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to do it after the gym. I'm like, okay, she's probably at work right now. We're at lunch. So I'm going to do it tonight. And then I'm like, I'm never going to do it. You know? And you like get in your own head. I'm like, guess I'm never going to do it. And it's so funny because after she said that night, I literally went home. And it's so simple. I was like 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And I just hit the talk button. I just started talking. And, you know, she intimidated me. I don't know why. And she just did. And she was like, you know what, girl? Like, thank you so much. Like, I'm not interested right now. She's trying to do like a YouTube page and all this kind of stuff. So she will become a distributor because we have the vehicle. Even if It Works is, this is what they were talking about too, which really hit me. Like, even if It Works is not your end goal, even if your goal is to open up a traditional business or whatever, this is the vehicle. If your goal is to open up a nonprofit, this is the vehicle, you know, like it is the vehicle. And she was like, no, like I'm not interested, but actually my mom has been looking for a distributor. She wants to become a distributor. She's been looking for somebody. And I was like, amazing. Okay. And I'm never going to stop like interacting with both of them, but I'm going to sign her mom up. And if I would have never just like 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, get out of my head. And it's so simple. Like you guys, the way that she broke it down, it was crazy. And you guys have heard us like it, the event changed our life. My first conference changed our life. You know, you always just see something click in someone and then all of a sudden they just explode. They don't care what people think. They've worked their butt off. They have no excuses and they just run and you're like, it clicked. And I see it now because like I've been through it and I know it and I recognize it. And you look at people and you're like, you're not hitting your full potential, but I pray that one day it will click. And that's that same thing. It doesn't take 10 years to change your life. It doesn't take a year to change your life. It takes 5 seconds. One decision, that's all it is. It just takes, you know, that one decision to decide that you're just gonna freaking do it and nothing's gonna stop you. And it's so funny that you took that exact same thing, because I was like, that's all. And that's what I was doing today. Like, my kids were freaking crazy. Aaron wasn't here and I could have made excuses. And I was like, you know what? Like, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And I even had kids screaming in the background. And I was like, I'm going to message her. And I've been too scared to message her. So yeah, that was amazing. And yeah, somebody said, so it's so funny how many people have never heard of it. You guys, we live in a social media bubble. And it's so funny because this lady, this is something I took away too. Like, I'm normally not like a statistics person, but I took away these numbers because it was crazy. This, I think it was actually Mel, maybe it was somebody else, but she, one of the people on there, she was at the top of her company, and she said that her two, you know, top people in her company or in her downline were in her team, and they both had 20 million in volume coming from each one of them. 20 million
a month.
Yeah, a month. Sorry, a month. Okay. Can you imagine 20 million from two people in your downline, that volume? And I was like, holy crap. And they're still growing. They're still growing. And I looked up her company and they're like a 25-year-old company and they're still growing. And I'm like, you guys, like, you don't even know. Like, you can decide now to be here in 5 years, in 10 years, and be like freaking making 100, 200, 300,000 a month. Or you could be lazy and be like, dang, remember that one time I was on that training and I just didn't do anything after that? And I should have, because Chrissy told me we were all going to be millionaires if we just worked hard. You just need to make the decision, because I'm going to be that person with 20 million coming from all my legs. It's crazy. But anyways, so, all right. So next to Eliana, you are next on the screen. All right.
All right, guys. Well, actually, surprisingly, that was my takeaway too. Besides all the greatness.
That's amazing.
The 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, guys, it's insane. Caesar and I have actually been using it just for even waking up and just doing things. And
yeah.
It's just the craziest thing. It really is. It's so simple. What did you say?
Yeah, just to get out of bed, she said she uses it. Like, no snooze button.
Yeah, simple stuff. Like, just get up. Exactly, just simple stuff, and you just basically trick your mind into it. But besides that, guys, make sure you take that with you tonight as well, just because you basically just got to force yourself. You know, your mentality – your brain is already designed for you, like how she said, it's already designed for you to kill that emotion in like more than 5 seconds. So if you didn't make it in 5 seconds, that's it. Like, you're not going to do it. Now, as far as like, oh my gosh, guys, we learned so many things. I don't even know where to start, but I have a few things written down here. So I wanted to touch base on the 4 D's, doubt, distractions, disappointments, and dream stealers. People need to realize, like, you're coming into this business with all of that, okay? Like, it's not going to be peaches and cream and you're going to race to the top. Like, you need to have already in your mindset that there is going to be plenty of doubters, plenty of haters, plenty of distractions. There's distractions everywhere you go. You can literally sit there and scroll your life away, and next thing you know, you didn't do anything. If you had 1 hour to work your business and you spent it scrolling, there goes your hour. You're going to have disappointments, guys. You're going to be disappointed in yourself, but you need to have mental strength, because without mental strength, you're not going to get anywhere. Like, you can know all the information. You could have watched every training video. You could be on every Monday. You can have your cute little notebooks, but if you do not take action and have mental strength to go for your goals, like, you're not going to get there. Like, that's literally the other part of like successful, like, to be the successful part. Dream stealers, guys, my goodness, they're walking everywhere. They're literally, I'm sorry to say this, but they're even in your own family. It could be your partner. It could be your best friend, your coworkers. Whoever is a dream stealer, you need to learn to, like, seriously stop that. Just have that mental strength. Do not let people steal your dreams. If Christy had let somebody steal her dream, guess what? None of us would be here. If I had let somebody steal my dream, none of my downline would be here. I wouldn't be where I am today. So, I mean, just get over that, guys. Get over, oh, somebody told me this, somebody commented that here, oh, somebody said that this doesn't work, oh, blah, blah, blah. Bullshit. I'm so sorry to say it, but seriously, guys, believe in your freaking comp plan. Believe in your product. Believe in you. Believe in our CEO. You are in the best company ever, and you need to, like, honestly, like how Christy said it, I'm going to say it, stop half-assing things. I've even half-assed my way to triple diamond. I can't even believe, like, I can't even imagine what giving it my 100% would look like, because I will be ambassador. That leads me into knowing. So one thing is like, oh, I believe in myself. I believe in myself. That's great. Do you know you're going to get there? Because one thing is believing and the other thing is actually knowing. So they said the person at the top, the leader, the person that actually is winning and getting those, you know, whatever, promotions, you name it, already knows. They already know they're getting there. They already believe they deserve it. You know, it's already done and said. It's just a matter of when. So stop, you know, trying and actually start believing that you are already there. Okay, now the next thing, when looking for leaders, guys, we're all capable of being leaders. But when you're looking for a leader, you need to know that that leader has to be confident, capable. They have to be committed and coachable, okay? And you have to be good communicators. So if you're looking for those leaders, make sure that you're looking for those kind of traits in those people. Capable, meaning like they are capable of looking at their own website for the prices. Literally things like that, guys. Be resourceful. Stop thinking that it's our job as our, like, the leaders for us to train you or, for us to give you every single answer on this planet. Like, you need to start being resourceful on your...
Hold on, Eliana, you froze.
Hold on, Eliana.
Did she freeze for all of you guys too?
Yes.
Okay. Eliana? Hold on. Eliana, you froze. Okay, hold on. You need to start being resourceful on your own. That's what she was going to say, but Eliana! Oh, okay. So she just jumped off. So I'm sure she's going to jump back on. We'll give her a minute, but don't slow down her energy. She's here. She's here. She's here. Be resourceful, guys. Stop being lazy. Do you think millionaires are lazy?
I made my binder already.
You made your what?
My binder.
Your binder?
Yeah, with all the product information like she suggested.
Oh, I'm like, who is talking? So while she's jumping back on, I'm going to kind of add on to something that she said, you guys. When she said that she half ate her way to triple and she knows she wasn't giving her best, I want you to ask yourself this question, okay? How much of yourself are you truly using? How much potential are you actually giving compared to what you know you could be giving? So my answer was 10%. I'm like, I am only giving my business 10%. And I believe that I've at times given like 60, 70, but I don't ever believe that I've given 100%. Like, because I know what I can do. And when you give yourself an honest number, that's when you're going to be like, damn, I suck. You don't have to think you suck, but you need to be giving yourself an honest, you know, question and an honest answer. How much are you actually giving? Because when you're sitting there and you're like, oh, my check, oh, it was only, you know, it only got a $10 raise. Well, how much did you actually improve? How many people did you actually put in? And again, while she's getting back on, this is another thing that I want to jump on. Employee versus entrepreneur mindset. You guys, this is huge. This is probably everything. So if anyone else wanted to talk about this, add on to it too. This is literally probably everything, because guess what? The reason people quit is because they don't get a employee mindset paycheck quick enough. So what I mean by that, they put in 2 weeks, where's my paycheck? Like, I worked 40 hours for 2 weeks. Where's my paycheck? It's not there. It's not there. This is not a 9-to-5. You are an entrepreneur. You are going to be putting in way more work in the beginning and seeing no reward. That's just how it is. That's just how it is. You know, like my first 3 months, I was selling individual wraps. I didn't even make a paycheck. After that, my check was like $50. And I was like, woo, ballin'. And if I would have been like, guys, I just worked for 3.5 months for $50. That is where those dream crushers and those naysayers get into your head. They're like, you've literally worked all this time and made $50. Like, how does that even make sense? But guess what? I am not an employee. I'm a friggin' entrepreneur, period, end of story. So I'm going to put in the time now to reap the reward later. There was actually one guy that he said that for 4 years, he worked his butt off. He worked his butt off, and I think he said his highest check was like $1,800. How many of you guys would still be here? Be honest. No. Like nobody. You'd be like, oh, heck no. Like, this isn't – and his family told him, like, are you dumb? You've been working this much time for $1,800 a month? Like what? And guess what he's doing now? Clearly, he was on that stage for a reason. He owns a bunch of different businesses, but the most important is that he is in the top of his network marketing company making a couple million a year. Okay. Is that worth it? Would you work 4 years really hard for nothing? Which we know in this business, if you actually work really hard, in 6 months, you'll be like making amazing money. And then you just got to work more and more and more and more. And you know, that's the thing, like you need to control your mindset, because otherwise when somebody asks you like, how many hours have you put in for a couple hundred dollars? Like, that doesn't make sense. If you don't have a vision for your business, if you don't have that belief, just like she was saying, in your business, in yourself, they are going to just wipe you out. That's it. They're going to wipe you out. And along with the belief thing that she was saying, you guys, like, you need to be using our products. You need to have a vision for what you're doing, a goal for what you're doing for not just yourself, but for other people, for your team. And you need to have the belief there, because if you don't have the belief there, when you tell somebody, I'm executive and I've been in the business for a year, they're going to be like, what? But guess what? If I was like, I'm a freaking executive, I'm a freaking entrepreneur, I've been in this business for a year, and guess what? In a year, I'm going to be a millionaire. They're going to be like, you're right, I'm joining your team. Like, that's just how it is. You have to have that belief and that energy and that vision for yourself. And that is what's going to take you further. Like, that's what's going to do it. Stacey,
hey, I'm in.
Oh, you're here. I just didn't see your face. I was just about to ask.
No, yeah, acting really stupid. And it like just, like, it died. It literally died. No, but I just want to really quickly finish, guys.
You were like, take responsibility for your own business.
And then it died. No, it's fine. My phone's literally been acting up lately. It's too much pictures. So I just want to end, guys, with just, you know, we have all been employees, and that's, you know, I can see why we all have thought about that, you know, or have had that mentality. But stop thinking employee with this business, because you are not an employee, guys. You're not here to trade your time. Like, we do not pay hourly. You're here in business for yourself, obviously not by yourself, but you need to start thinking about, you know, for example, an employee will trade time for money. You are trading blood, sweat, tears, sacrifice, you what name extra. It. Everything, exactly, for something that's going to pay off. And guess how? It'll pay off like no other job will pay you. I, like, cannot go to any job right now, and they'll never pay me what I make right now. So it might be a little bit of stuff in at the beginning. Like, you're like, for example, my paycheck at the very beginning, guys, $25, okay? I mean, I could have been like, F this crap. Like, what the hell? I just put in God knows how long time and whatever, and $25, that got me what, gas? But you need to start, like, putting your turning your expectations to appreciation. Like, $25, you might have just made that on the freaking couch at home, Okay. But all that will be bigger and bigger and bigger each time. But if you keep having a mentality of an employee, you will never become a business owner. And another thing, guys, like, learn to be disciplined on your own. A boss will tell you to get up, or maybe they'll, like, you're fired if you don't come to your job. But a business owner knows already what to do without being told to anything to do so. Like, I'm not going to call you and be like, hey, did you post today? Hey, did you go and message that one potential? You need to do it on your own, guys. And the honestly, like, the bottom line is, we all know what to do. You know what to do. You know how to sign LCs. You know how to sign DTs. You already know everything. Okay. It's just the action part. It's so easy to do it that it's so easy not to do it. So that's basically that, guys. And another thing is, people are attracted to the lifestyle that we can offer, the ability to be at home with your kids, to go anywhere. If in case you get, you know, you fall and break a leg, you're at home working still from your phone, but you're not, like, so many of you are stuck on selling the product, selling the, get a business kit, selling the product and this and that, and stop being so salesy and start maybe more like building those relationships and communicating with people and, you know, showing how it can change their lives, because people want that connection. Trust me, people need these products and need this, you know, business. But if you keep coming off salesy, they're going to run away from you. People don't want to be sold something. They want an opportunity to change their life, but you got to show it to them. So that's mine, guys. I have like a million more, but I'm going to go on because a lot of people others have to talk. So hope you guys got a bunch of good tips from us, guys.
You're not going anywhere, are you?
No, I'm here.
You act like
my phone dies. Unless my phone dies again.
Just so you guys know, if you take nothing away from this, go do some personal development. Okay, I know I'm wrong. I have made the mistake by saying that I don't read, because I don't. But guess what? I do other types of personal development, you know, which might be watching The Secret, that might be watching a YouTube video, whatever. And Eliana and I were on a phone conversation, which was weird because we never actually talk on the telephone. It's always just Voxer. But I said, like, all right, we got to read some books. And if you don't read, listen on audio, okay?
Hi, baby.
Audio is just as good, if not better, at least for me. Go do some personal development. And I know that we buy books and that doesn't mean crap. We can leave them at home and put them in a drawer, because Eliana and I both have done it. But go listen to something. The more you grow, that's when your belief is going to grow. That's when your team's going to grow. That's just you as a person is going to grow. Like, you don't see people on stage like, all right, I'm not really confident, but I'm making $100,000 a month. Like, they don't do that. They're like, bitch, get to work. You know, like, they have so much fire and confidence in themselves. Like, that's why they're like, okay, you said no, bye, 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 bye. You said yes. Okay, bye, bye, bye. Yes, you know. So, anyways, all right, I'm going to move on because, like she said, we got lots of people. Tommy. So, Tommy, you went, like, basically one full day between
6 hours.
Six hours. She went 6 hours. And she's like, best thing ever. Yeah. Go ahead.
I know. I can't imagine how, like, drunk off of the glory you guys are, because I was only there for 6 hours, and I was like, I'm, like, driving, calling my husband, like, you won't believe that they said this and this, and my notes, my phone is, like, because I didn't have that book. I just have, like, my phone. But my biggest thing is kind of, like, what you were talking about just now about the no's, because, like, I'm only my third month, and I'm not used to, like, messaging people. I'm an extrovert if I know you, but I am a huge, like, shy, like, really shy. And I, like, disgusted myself now looking back at last week, like, of how I talked to somebody, because I was just like, oh, okay. And now I'm like, oh. Because what they said, that is, fear is focusing on you. And that to me was huge, because I don't mind posting, I don't mind blitzing, handing out cards, but it's the actual messaging people, which is the biggest thing I think that we need to do, is actually, like, message somebody and be like, hey, are you interested? Because just in the last few days, I've talked to, like, 10 people, and last week, I talked to, like, 4 people, maybe, you know? So, this, they said that to make the decision, that it's not about getting, it's about giving. So you don't mind if they say no, because somebody out there is going to say yes, that, like, literally you just want to give them, like, this gift. You're not like, oh, what can I get? What promotion can I get? What bonus can I get? Like, it's good to have goals, but you're giving them like an opportunity. So that's, because that was me. I was just scared to message them and then be like, no, like you're annoying or whatever. And so that was huge for me. And the personal development budget, like how you guys keep saying to books and stuff, because the products, like I have a few products, but like how much they were saying, like how much do you want to make or how much are you making and how much are you investing into your business compared to like how much you want to get, like if you want to get $10,000 but you aren't willing to spend $50 to make yourself better or buy yourself a product or listen to a book or go to an event to further grow your business, then you have issues. And I was like, I have issues. I need to buy some stuff.
I have issues.
So that was mine. It was awesome. And I'm going to just like you said, like open up, stop being so like hermit crabby, treat them like they're your best friend and know that you're giving them a gift, especially with this business. It is a gift. It really, really is. So
yeah, you guys, like imagine if you message somebody and you're just like in the voice message and you're just like, oh my gosh, I just want to share something with you. Like, I don't know if you're going to be interested, but I had to share it with you because you're freaking awesome.
Yeah.
Even if they say no, they're going to be nice about it. Because guess what? You were confident about it and they clearly see that you love it. So they're just going to be like, you know what? Like, I'm not super interested in it, but thank you. Like, they're still going to be nice about it if you are just like, boom. And then you're going to be like, okay. Because they weren't like, you suck. They're just like, no, it's okay. And part of what she said too, this is something that really hit me. Make the you can find them off of social media because there was like a social media panel, but you need to make the connection offline. You know, get them online and take them offline to make that connection. And that really hit me because I feel like some of us are able to make the connection on and offline, but not everybody's able to do that. That takes like a lot of learning and a lot of like, hey, you know, like it just takes a lot. And even then, that is why I want that connection. And that is why I also train or took the second Monday and made it in person for new distributors, because I want to see you guys. I want to get to know you guys. I don't want to just be like, hey guys, I'm just training you online all the time. So I wanted to do that. And also that's why I set up a party or an opportunity meeting for Wednesday, because every single one of them does that. We think that everybody uses social media. Like not a lot of people do. And they were like, you know, we have these opportunity meetings and yada, yada. And I was like, that's true. Like, I need to get them offline and get them in person to make that true connection. Because if I can get somebody in front of me, if I can take them to lunch or whatever, like, they will sign because they can't help it. They just can't help it. So that was a huge thing for me, you guys. Like, and maybe getting them offline is not in person. Maybe it's just getting them on the phone. Whatever you need to do, just get them offline to make that connection with them. Because you could sign 15 distributors, and guess what? You don't know none of them. They are not going to do crap. Well, some of them might, but if you don't know any of them, if you never talk to them again, they're going to be like, eh, whatever. They're not going to see what you see because they don't know you. But if you make it a friendship, a connection with 5 or 6 of them, guess what? They're going to be like, I don't quite get it, Savannah, but guess what? You're excited, so I'm excited. Let's do it. You know, like ignorance on fire takes you a lot farther than knowledge on ice. Okay, so who's up next? Savannah. And Savannah went all 2.5 days. And you know what? I just want to give her a shout out because she always shows up. She
what?
Just shows up, you know?
Kidding.
She shows up so she can go up.
What?
Okay. And there's a lot of guys that are amazing too, but you don't live here and stuff. So that's fine. You know, I don't want to make anyone feel bad. But anyways, sorry.
Yeah, you always choose me. Anyways, I'm just kidding. I took so much out of the event. Like, I've been so on fire just like everybody else. I walked into Walgreens today and like blitzed 4 ladies and they're coming over Wednesday to have a wrap party with me. So like, that was totally out of my comfort zone. And anybody that knows me personally, like, I really don't even have a comfort zone because I'm super comfortable, like, talking to anybody. That's one thing about myself that I've always had that helps me in the business. But I've just, like,
older people kind of scare me, like people that I know I can relate to, like moms with kids or whatever, but these ladies were like just different than me. And I think that's kind of where it was, it's like hard for me to approach them, but I did it and I just got out of my way. And they were also excited. I've worked at Walgreens before, so I kind of like played into it, even though it was like when I was 19, but who cares, right? So a couple things that I took out of it. One was just like the basics, obviously, that we talk about all the time. But three things that a guy that I really liked, Jay Bennett, that he said was, you know, we have to use the products. And I know that's just so simple, you guys, but I know that so many of my distributors, and I might be calling you out right now, but they don't even use the product. And then they expect to like have these massive results with this business. And it's like, what? Using the product is essential. Unless you have that visual of yourself using the product, you are not going to have that personal connection with your customers or your potentials. So number two, he said, was just talking to people. I proved that today when I just walked in and talked to those ladies and now I'm having a wrap party. Talk to more people. Like the 5-foot rule, I think somebody said, like anytime someone's around you in 5 feet, you have an opportunity to approach them. And just like Stacy talking to that lady at Subway, who could be her next runner, you know, you never know who's going to be there. And we've said it all before, but the next thing was just, our company or our business is we get paid for our word of mouth advertising. So how do you expect to earn a paycheck if you're not opening your mouth? That's what we do. That's what network marketing is. We have a lot of great tools through social media. But just like Christy said, like 2 minutes ago, half of our company as well is having meetings, sitting down with people, like making friendships with people. How do you expect to be an ambassador and not have a network behind you of people that are willing to run with you and go to the end with you? And so that was just something. Don't expect to reinvent the wheel because you're not going to. If you're trying to like, obviously we want you to be yourself. We don't want you to like be just at works. But if you think that you're going to have a better way than Christy, you're wrong. Like, she got there by getting there by following other people who got there, and that's what we're all doing who will get there. And it sounds so silly, but it's simple, and it's very much a reality. And then, obviously, just using all of our tools, you guys. We don't talk to, like, hear ourselves talk. We actually want to help you guys. We're here to be your leaders and mentors, and we want you to succeed. We want you to be a part of that 5% that works hard enough to get to the top, and you have to pay the price to be there. It's not an easy road, and I can tell you guys, you know, I have days just like Christy had that, you know, when she shared that 2.5 days, like, I got emotional about it because I've been there, and it's hard. Like, you don't want to tell – I don't even like telling people when I'm in a funk or, like, depressed because who wants to hear that?
You make it last longer.
Right. It's like I'll stay here a little bit longer now. And so, but you guys, if you are in that and you're in your own head, you won't have momentum. And momentum is like critical in this business. It's going to create your environment and your future. And so you just have to cling on to that. So that's really what I took out. But it was amazing. Everything about it was amazing. But you guys, I can say, I still think our conference is better. So if you're not going, get yourself to the conference.
There's obviously something different about, you know, your own company's conference.
Your own green.
Yeah.
But yes, go to conference, get there. It's just like, I mean, if you guys, another thing that someone had said was like those feelings that eat us alive, that just destroy our business, like the jealousy and comparison. These are all things that I see that I do, you know, and I think it's natural. But with that 5-second rule that ironically and hilariously, that was the one thing that was just like there in my head, and I've been using it since I left. So to hear all of you guys have that same thing, it was really quite funny.
There's actually a TED Talk. I don't even know what that is, but I think they said a TED Talk or a podcast. I don't know all that crap, but I will try to find it. She said she goes into depth more, but you know, even if I don't find it, don't wait for me to find it. Just use it. It's very simple. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, boom, just do it. It's so funny that like that was like huge for all of us. Like it's crazy. And okay, so let's see here. There was something I wanted to say, but I forgot. So I'm gonna move on. Okay. Heather, you ready? Are you ready?
Hi, yeah, sorry. I'm actually at an event really quick, so give me 1 sec. I'm just gonna step out.
An event.
Hello? Sorry, can you hear me?
Yeah, you're fine. Go ahead.
Okay. Sorry. I was like at an event trying to help one of my DTs and stuff like that.
Oh, like, so, like a booth event.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, what event are you at? Why are you here?
So the one thing that also stood out to me, there's a lot, but I'll just pick one. They were talking about the millennials, and they were just saying how, like, the millennials, they're, like, the fresh blood. They're the new people that's going to want to be more open to opportunities, you know? Like, someone was talking about, like, how, you know, you guys were there, or those are the group that was at the kitchen table when their grandparents were talking about, like, their jobs, and then their parents were talking about the jobs, and, you know, they saw their struggle. And with network marketing, it just gave more of like a different opportunity. Yeah. Oh, hello? I don't know what's going on. Hello?
I can hear you.
I can hear you.
Okay, sorry. It's just like on my screen, it was like all different. Okay. So, so they were talking about how, like, the millennials, they're the ones who's going to have that fire lit up in them and stuff like that. So, yeah. And then I just thought, like, that was like a good aha moment, because sometimes I think the millennials, like, they're the ones who are looked down upon, when really they're not. They're the next generation that's going to bring new light to the world and all that stuff. So, yeah, I thought that was pretty cool. And so, yeah, and then it just shows, you know, like, ordinary jobs now, sometimes they're not as great. Sometimes even being a doctor, a lawyer, people at this event, people who were lawyers, people who were realtors, people who were, like, you know, those high-end jobs, they ended up having something in their lives where they had to find residual income. So when they found the residual income, they were like, okay, I'm going to go and do this instead. I was able to replace my income and stuff like that. And it provided them with more options. So that's exactly what, you know, our business does. So I was just like, that's true. And that's it.
You guys, like, this business, just adding on to what she said, like, this business lets ordinary people become extraordinary. Like, you know, those people, they're like hard workers. They become doctors. They become lawyers, whatever. Like, don't be afraid to show them the opportunity either, because they clearly have a good work ethic, but that doesn't mean that, you know, you have to discriminate, because I don't discriminate, you know, like, I'll talk to a stay-at-home mom, but don't be afraid to talk to somebody that has a good job, because guess what? They're motivated for more. And like she was saying, a lot of those people that were doctors and lawyers or whatever, they're like, yeah, but I wanted, you know, more. And more means more hours. And I knew that there had to be a better way. And that's network marketing, you know, that's us. That's our company. So, okay, let's see here. Who's next? Jamie.
Hi.
Let me turn you up.
We're decorating our tree.
That's okay.
You muted me.
Okay, sorry. Go ahead.
All right. So I think I can't remember his name. I think it was Carruthers or something like that. But I loved when he said, okay, I'm so excited about my business, and I'm going to talk to all my friends. And so he's like, hey, you want to hear about my business? And they're like, no. And he thought, oh, okay. Hey, you want to hear about my business? And they're like, no. And he's like, oh, okay. Hey, do you want to hear about my business? And they're like, no. And then again, hey, you know, I got this business. Would you maybe want to hear about it? And he's like, you can't do that. Like, just because you're getting the no's, don't let it bring down your morale. Like, don't let it decrease your passion and your excitement, because people are going to see that and they're going to feed off of it. And then if you're not excited, like, why would they be excited about it? So you're going to get more and more no's, you know, and just think of it, he said, as, like, you get your $100 fast start bonus. So if it takes you 9 people before you get a yes on the 10th, that person just made you $10. Like,
the no, every single no made you $10.
Okay. No made you $10. So think of it that way. Like, Okay, well, thanks for listening. You just made me $10. I totally appreciate it. I love that part because I was like, that's totally true.
I'm going to use it. I'm totally going to use it. Like, oh, that's fine. I just made $10 talking to you. And they're going to be like,
thank you. And then I liked his example with the popcorn. Like, you know, if you put it in the microwave and you kind of just pretend to press the buttons, your popcorn's never going to pop. Like, you can open the door and you can look at it, but nothing has bloomed. Like, no popcorn has blossomed. Like, it's still just the same. So you can't just go through the motions and pretend like you're working and expect results.
Sorry, go ahead.
And then just when Tony had said, you know, if you're kind of getting in a mood, like, your motion is your energy. So, like, get yourself out of it. Like, move and have your own little dance party or something, you know, and, like, get yourself out of that. Because when you're moving, that's your energy. And high energy is when you're going to produce results. And then just one other thing is I hear all the time people saying, like, I'm not an extrovert. I'm not high energy. And Eric Worre said, I'm an introvert. Like, this is my jam right here, and I'm a situational extrovert. So, you know, you can teach yourself to do it, and the habit of that, like, whether you're scared to make videos, you're scared to message people, you're scared to talk to people, like, just do it. Like,
be an actor.
Be an actor, and then you'll overcome that fear. Like, it's taken him a while, but you would never know that he would consider himself an introvert, but he called himself a situational extrovert. So
that was that popcorn thing. So the way that I took away from it, it's so funny how, like, different minds take different things away from it. Like, hers was like, you know, you can't just go through the motions, but mine with the popcorn was you have to be consistent. Cause to me, he was, you know, opening it up and then he'd start it for a couple seconds and then he'd stop it. And then he'd start it for a couple seconds and then he'd stop it. And then he'd start it for a couple more seconds and then he'd stop it. And he said, guess what? You could do this for 4 years, but guess what? At the end of the 4 years, you are still not going to have any popcorn. You are still going to be opening and closing and turning it on. You are not going to ever have any popcorn. And to me, like, that was like, you need to be consistent. You need to be consistent. You cannot be consistent one full day and then be like, I don't feel like it today. Sorry, I'll start again tomorrow. Like, you can't do that. You have to be consistent. And the other thing, that was so funny, that thing that he did, the last person he asked, he's like, you don't want to make money. You know, it went from like, I have this business. Oh my gosh, you should hear about it. And then it was like, you don't want to make money, do you? But if you think about it, like, every no is 10 bucks. Most people work an hour for 10 bucks or less, actually. And so if you just think, like, every person I ask is 10 bucks because you, like, you know, round it up, at the end of that 10, someone's going to say yes, and then you're going to be like, oh, cool, I just made 100 bucks. Like, thank you for at least listening to me. You just made me $10. So they're going to be like, wait, what? I want to make $10 by talking to somebody, you know? That was awesome. Like, I'm going to write that down again because I have, like, 12 notes in my phone and I can't even, like, sort through them. Okay. Sheena. Hi, Sheena.
Hello. Sorry, I'm turning on the light. My internet's being all weird.
No, you're fine.
Okay. So mine was, when Tony Robbins was talking about breakthroughs and, he had used like an example of, you know, like talking about a guy that was like, oh, you know, I've tried everything to lose weight. I've tried like, you know, thousands of different things. And he's like, oh, really? You've tried thousands of different things. So like, well, maybe not thousands, but for sure a few hundred. And then he's like, oh, okay, well, maybe not a few hundred, but I've tried a few, you know, and just really got it narrowed down. Like, when you really want something bad enough, like you can get yourself just to like in a second, like stop smoking. It just takes, you know, like an instant. Like when you put your mind to it, you just make that decision and it's your breakthrough. And he was also talking about like how your mind works. So a lot of times, you know, this has all happened to us and it had all happened to people in the audience. where you're sitting at like the dinner table and, you know, say like your husband's like, hey, can you pass me the salt? And you're like, oh gosh, like, I don't even know where the salt is. And of course, they're like, yes, you do. It's like, you know, right as soon as you open the cabinet, it's on the bottom shelf. And so you don't really want to, you know, get up and get the salt. So you walk over there and you're like, you know, scrambling through all the seasonings and you're like, I can't find the salt. And then they come over and they, you know, like find it immediately. But you told yourself, like, you know, you didn't want to do it. And you're like, I think they said like your mind physically, like puts up a block. So your eyes see it, but your brain doesn't comprehend that. So how many times, you know, like, does that happen with us with things, you know, the negative thoughts we're thinking, like, you know, I'm not attracting any distributors. Like, I can't sign any distributors. Like, you know, no one's messaging me and blah, 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 blah. All those negative thoughts, really, like, it's physically and mentally putting up a block. So we really have to watch what we're saying and what we're feeding our minds. So that's one of the main things I took away.
That was so funny. It's like totally true. You're like, oh, I don't see it anywhere. And they come up and they're like, it's freaking right in front of your face. You're like, oh, no, it wasn't. You put it there.
Right. Yeah. So he said like divorce. What do you say? Divorce your story and marry the truth. You know,
woo, I like that, guys.
I know, that was really good.
Katie, stop your fooling around. Can't handle it. You're like my kid sitting on my lap. I can't handle it.
Are you squirreling?
I'm squirreling. I'm like, and your guys' screens are right above each other. So I'm like, ah, can't handle it. But it's okay. Sorry. It's okay though, because you got good energy and it's fine. Do you have a Lumi case? Because your face looks so bright and fabulous.
No, I'm sitting, well, the bar is completely empty and I have a little light above a light above my computer. So yeah, my phone died. So I'm just kind of chilling.
I was like, dang. Okay. So let's see here.
You need one of these.
I do need one of those. Look at how dark I am. Okay. I'm going to mute you. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so somebody else go, because some of your guys' names are all rambled, and I know there's, like, way more than you. Way more. Wasn't Diana on here? Did she already go?
I'm here.
Where are you? Where's your face?
Right here.
Okay, go ahead. I can't see your face. Oh, there you are. Okay. Okay.
Hi. So you guys kind of went over everything that I was going to talk about, but one of the biggest things that made me even decide that this is what I'm going to be doing for the rest of my life. Like this, I've never been so sure that this is what I want to be doing, but who said this? I think it was Eric Ward, but it's, oh my God, my energy starts going like, oh, all crazy just thinking about this, but he said, is this a phase in life or a way of life? So it's a matter of making that decision, truly believing in yourself and deciding. Can you guys still hear me?
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's just Christy who's frozen. But it's just making that decision in life and making that, you know, truly believing in yourself and knowing that you deserve this and knowing where you're going to be going. Be intentional and just take action. Be excited about the same thing over and over again. Be excited about talking about your products, about offering this business to people, because when you don't offer it, you're doing a disservice. So that's the way I've been thinking about it now. But what else? Have courage, be the leader, and just go after it. Another thing about that quote or what he had said, is this a phase in life or is this a way of life? If not network marketing, then what will you do? For me, I never went to college. So I know for a fact, I'm not going to be going to another job where I'm working 40 plus hours and making the same amount of money, versus where I'm at home working my butt off. And I know that next year I'm going to be making Well, my goal, I'm going to be making over $15,000 a month, over $20,000 a month. And you know why? It's because I've decided and I know I'm going to be getting there. I get so emotional, you guys. It's just, it's sad to see people, you know, that far in life. And they say, if your goals don't, I don't know how to say it, but yeah, but basically just, you know, making the decision that this is what you're going to be doing, and stay committed and fall in love with the process, because they say success is not a success is not a destination, it's a journey. And I know that, you know, this, like they say, this company has its up and downs, and I'm going to be enjoying every hill, every up and down. So that's basically it. I get so excited, you guys. I'm like,
good.
The whole thing was just.
So to add kind of what onto something that she said that I just want to say really quick before I forget it. You know, you guys, you get all excited, you get all pumped. But the thing with entrepreneurs is you go home and you're by yourself. You work by yourself. You know, like, that is why that personal development and making those connections with people is so important, because guess what? Like, nobody's going to call you. Nobody's going to tell you what to do. Like, it's a lonely business sometimes, you know, like, you got to work your butt off by yourself, wherever you are, you know, even if you're meeting people every day, like, you have to work by yourself. And that's kind of where you just have to have that discipline and do that personal development just to, you know, keep yourself going. Like, keep that fire, you know? And that's why I'm going to get this up right away so you guys can rewatch it if you want. Okay, let's see here. There was, Genesis. There you are. I was looking for your face. And like, all you guys are showing up. I know on the East Coast it's a little bit later, but like, I'm so glad that so many of you guys are still on here, because we're just talking and talking and talking and talking. But it's fine. Okay. So, Genesis, did I unmute you? Where'd you go? Oh, thought I unmuted you. Okay, go ahead.
So, my favorite part about the event, I mean, there was so much that happened that it took me, like, literally the entire time that you guys were talking to really pinpoint something that I loved the most. But I want to say it was Rita Davenport. She was... she's goals. I want to be her when I grow up. She was amazing. And I want to one day walk around with two watches so I can say the same thing. but what I liked about the one thing that stuck from her was the abundance mentality versus the scarcity mentality. And I hear it all the time. I hear it from some of my, you know, my downline telling me, like, you know what, I don't want to do this anymore. Everybody does it, works, everybody knows about it, and it's not making any money. But it's not true. Like, we are a tiny company. There is huge companies, Mary Kay, Avon, Herbalife, all those companies have been here longer, and I mean, there's still people that are making millions in those companies.
They're still growing. We're such a
small, yeah, they're still growing. And if we're such a small company, I don't understand how it's possible that people can believe that it's limited to just Vegas, that everybody's already done it, that nobody wants it anymore. That's not true. We gotta believe, you know, that there are more people out there, because there are, and we just gotta stick to it. Keep trying. Keep working harder. And the other thing was, don't confuse disappointment with disaster, which is something that I have done over and over again. I'm such a drama queen, and you guys can ask Diana about it. Like, I will cry over nothing. Like, I want to cry right now because I'm nervous. But yeah, don't confuse it. You know, you're going to be disappointed. There's going to be days when everyone says no to you. That does not mean that you quit. You just keep pushing harder for the next day. You got to keep positive. You got to keep talking to people. Right after the event, I came home and I was literally shaking because I was freaked out. Like, there's no other way to say it. Like, I was totally freaked out. I didn't know how to process what I learned. And I decided that we were, well, me and Diana decided that we were going to do a wrap party on Wednesday. And she's like, okay, invite a few people. And I kind of went overboard and I invited 25 people. And I've gotten 4 no's. I've gotten 5 yeses. And the rest haven't answered me yet. So I still got till Wednesday. But yeah, that was my favorite part.
4 no's and 5 yeses. That's like really good. That's like really good odds. Like really good. That is awesome. Okay. Do any of you guys remember the whole thing with the watches? It was so funny. Rita yes. Davenport. She's exactly, she's me. Like, I want to be here when I grow up. Like, she was just funny. She was like, just so funny. You're just like, yeah, like, who cares? Like, who cares what anyone else is doing? Like, who cares if somebody says no? Like, bye. And that was totally like, you know, you connect with different people. Like, that's where I was like, yes. Like, bye. Like, you know, like, just water off the back, you know, and she just had the best sense of humor ever. Do any of you guys remember how she explained the watch thing? So she had a, like, a $20 watch and then a Rolex watch that she said was like $30,000. Do any of you guys remember?
Me.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, go ahead.
Wait, who?
Whoever said me.
Oh, me, Genesis, sorry.
Do you remember,
you
like,
hear me?
Do you remember how she explained it?
Yeah, she basically said, I wear 2 watches. One so that I can see the time, which was her $20 watch, and one so that you can see me, which was her $39,000 Rolex. And it was diamond encrusted.
Ballin'! Right. Which is awesome. Yeah. And you guys, like, that's, like, where she was, like, she was the funniest little old lady in the universe. Like, she was just hilarious. Like, she's, like, you're right. She's like, there's nothing sexier than a rich woman. And I was like, it was so funny. You know, but obviously then, you know, there was actually another guy. He's like, I came here in a Lamborghini. He's like, but, I don't know. I can't remember exactly how he explained it, but he's like, you know, but what really mattered is that when, you know, my grandma got sick, I was able to be with her the whole time. No one else was. I was able to be with her the whole time because I had the time, I had the income, and, like, you know, it's a good balance, like, to be ballin', but also to be a good person and giving and care about people. Like, there's no other business in the world that you can do that. Like, there's just none. This is it. This is it. And just like what she said too, I was like, if not this, then what? You're going to go work a 9-to-5 for the next 60 years to hopefully retire with something. Cause they don't do pensions anymore in a lot of companies. So anyways. Okay. Who is next? You guys can just, unmute yourself. Whoever's next. I can't, like, see everyone at once. So Eliana, who is your other people? Are they on here? I'm trying to find their faces.
Hey, I'm sorry. I'm going to talk real quick just cause, there's a, I couldn't even write it all down, but Jasenia, she wanted to know the 4 D's again, and that's doubt, distractions, disappointments, and dream stealers. So hopefully you got that, girl. And as far as somebody else, yeah, Jackie. Jackie should be on here.
I'm here.
Oh, there you are. Okay. Hi. Okay, go for it. Your turn.
Okay. So I have written down here a few things. I mean, everyone went over it already. But yes, so there was a quote that I really, really loved. It said, success without fulfillment is the ultimate failure. I love that. And it's Williams, the actor that killed himself. That story, I heard it before, and it was so, so sad. I'm like, I freaking loved him. Oh, my God. And I cried when I found out. But yes, like, basically that and employee don't have the mindset of employee, have the mindset of entrepreneur. I always been procrastinating, some more procrastinating. And and I would think, I remember Christy, I would watch the team meetings, I will hop in, and then I remember saying, stop thinking it's going to come to you, and, you know, like, stop, oh, I message one person. Wow, you know what? They're gonna wait for them to reply. No, like that was me. And then a couple of weeks, I reached out to Eliana before she invited me, and I was like, Eliana, you know what? I'm done with, with the BS. I'm just done, because I was thinking, like, it's crazy how these people brought everything up. I felt like they were talking to me. I'm like, oh my God, how did you know? Like, how did you know I was thinking that? Like, I was like, oh my God. And yes, so basically, like, if not network marketing, what? You know, because I'm like, what else am I gonna do? Like, what else is there? A job? Oh, a job that pays you $20, $30? Okay, cool, whoopee-doo. You know, like, that's not what I want, because, you know, just the whole thing of the job and the freedom and all that stuff. I want the freedom. I want to be able to help people. I want to be able to change lives. I want to tell people there's other options. It's not just like go to school, get a career, get a job, the basic. And I'm like, I am not a basic chick. I cannot be doing this. I'm with my mom too. And I'm like, hello, my mom. I want to have my house, worrying about me, So there's so many things, obviously. My son, and just like what I want to provide for him. And I'm like, I cannot do anything else besides network marketing. I got introduced to network marketing when I was 18 years old, and it's been a journey. And since then, I've been looking for something that I really liked. And now for a couple of years, I was like, what is it? And I was like, God, please, I want to do network marketing. And I know I do. And then boom, Eliana posted something about, we were talking about Tony Robbins, and she put a post about the book. And I was like, oh my God, I love him. I read him, his books and his audios and blah, blah. And then that's how Eliana invited me to this event, because she knew that I loved him and stuff. And so I'm so grateful that I went there, because honestly, I already had decided that I was gonna do this, but this was just like an extra like slap, like hurry up, girl, like just get it together and just do this. So yeah, that's basically what that was.
That probably was like the funniest thing ever. Like, I am not a basic chick.
I'm a basic chick.
You're like, I am not a basic. I'm literally writing that down because that was hilarious. but yeah, that's amazing. And you know what? Like, Eliana's personal development, which, all she did was post a book, that signed the distributor. You guys, like, people, they want to be happy. They want to be positive. They want to be excited. They want to be motivated. Like, you got to be that person that provides the way, because guess what? When you go on Facebook, there's so many other like negative things. Like, even though people feed into the other stuff, like what they really want is that happiness. The happiness, they want to be happy. They want to be excited. You know, like they want to be that. You just have to open up the door for it, Okay. And I don't want to kill this, but Yarimis, am I saying it right? Yarimis.
It's your Yarimis.
Yarimis. Even better. Yarimis.
Okay. Can you guys hear me?
Poquito.
Poquito?
Yeah.
Okay, what about now? Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry, it's because I'm in the car. So, two things really stood out to me, but one of them we already talked about. It was how it's honestly not about you, it's about them. And we already talked about that. The more you start learning that it's about them, start helping to change people's lives, that's when your life is going to change, because you're giving out and you're willing to help somebody else, and it's going to come back to you, and your life is going to change too. And then the other thing that really stood out to me also was build your brand. Make yourself stand out from that other It Works distributor. Make them feel comfortable to come to you instead of, hey, their cousin sells it, but I feel way comfortable talking to you. And you always follow up with me. You always comment on my pictures. We're always having a conversation. So you got to set yourself apart and build your own brand and have people just flock to you. And those are the really two things that, like, really stood out to me. And even today, like, I get shy messaging people. But today I was like, I'm changing so many people's lives. I'm changing yours. And I'm going to help be a stay-at-home mom. I'm helping everybody. So was so excited, and it motivated me so much, and I'm so happy and grateful that I actually went. So, yay!
I'm glad that you came too. You guys, like, if you're scared of messaging, like, do that 5-4-3-2-1 thing. Like, I promise you it will work. Like, it will work. And you know what? That was a huge part. I don't even know why I didn't like think of it, because there was just so much information to take in. But building your brand, like, what makes you stand out from other people? Richard Branson, he owns Virgin Airlines and obviously like a bajillion other companies. Like, he's amazing. And what he was saying too is like, they don't spend a lot of money on advertising. They get creative. Like, their competitor is British Airways. And, you know, British Airways spent all this money, you know, trying to take them out and yada, yada, yada. But they would do like stuff that would make them stand out. So they had like a Ferris wheel that they had built, and obviously probably have their brand all over it and all that kind of stuff. And like, they weren't like finishing building it on time or something like that. And so what his company did was they went and they took like those like air floats, you know, that say stuff on them. And they said like, oh, BA, so British Airways can't get it up. And like, And then on the other side, it just had like Virgin Islands. You know how much free advertisement that got them? And there was other stuff, that other examples that they used, where it was like billions of dollars it would have costed for certain advertisements that they did for free, because they were just creative. They made themselves stand out. You know, make that value on yourself. Another example was one of the Tony Robbins was talking with somebody, and he had just moved to a new place, and he was like this young kid trying to be a real estate agent in this place that was like very high end. And people looked at him like, you're a little kid, like whatever. So he said, you need to stand out. You need to do something to make yourself stand out. Give yourself a brand, give yourself like, you know, a name for yourself. So he didn't go and spend money on, you know, thousands of advertisements, whatever. There was a trash strike. And all he did was he called in a company that cost him a few thousand dollars and had the trash taken out of this certain area. And people thought, oh my gosh, like the trash strike is over. And then they talked to other people and they're like, the trash strike is not over. Like, somebody stole my trash. Like, what the crap? And he didn't say, I did it. He didn't like, you know, talk out loud. He wasn't like, oh, I did it. Like, come be my client. You know, it got out that it was him, and they just said like, why did you do this? And they said, okay, you know, we'll pay you for it. Like, we'll pay you. And he said, no, don't you dare take any money from them. And he didn't take any money. And he said, okay, well, what can we do? And he said, you know what, if you are buying or selling a house or know anyone that is, refer them to me. And I think they said the next year he made like $4 million in just sales from buying and selling houses in real estate. All because he did one little kind gesture that made him stand out from the rest, you know? So just make yourself stand out. And honestly, that's just by like being more personal, you know, and more caring about other people. Okay. So is there anybody else? Eliana, do you have anybody else? There was a couple other people, but I think they weren't able to get on earlier. And so they are just on the live. Anyone, if you are, unmute yourself and speak up, please, or forever hold your peace. No? Okay. I think that's it. Okay, guys. Excuse me. So I'm going to get this recording up, but you guys like take away from this that you need to do some personal development. You know, you need to dream bigger and do some personal development on yourself. And when you focus on others, like that's when your business is going to explode. If anybody has any questions, you can put it in the chat right now. But also next week, just so you guys know, next week at my house on Monday, I'm going to do a new distributor training, you know, for the basics, because I want to see people and get to know people. Yeah, Katie.
So just from like a recap of everyone that I've seen, I actually just had an aha moment, and I just felt like I should share. And yeah, it's part of being consistent. And I mean, being consistent is very, very, very huge. And I was very consistent for 6 months. I went double diamond in 6 months, and not a lot of people know that. And I have been in the business for, it was a year, October 26th. And I have not promoted since then. And I felt like I was very, very, very consistent for 6 months. And after that, I got so comfortable that, you know, I just felt like, oh, you know, people are just going to fall in my lap. And that's not how it goes. Absolutely not. And now I am backtracking, and it's a pain in the freaking booty to try and, you know, like pick up the puzzle pieces and keep going. So, my advice to all of you guys that, you know, if you feel like you have pushed so far and it's so hard for you to pick it back up, like all it takes is basically just reconnecting back to the trainings and listening to everything that's going on. And it's just like Christy said, you know, like she'll vox for me, and, you know, little do I know that she needs me as much as I need her, and her and I both kind of connect in that way. And no matter what the negativity or no matter what's going on with, you know, my business or her business or what I have going on in my life or what's going on in her life, like, you find that one person that you can connect with, and you just have to keep going. Like, that's just it, you know. And then another thing that kind of was punched into my face is, you know, yes, everyone has another job. And you just have to look at it at, like, you know, you talk to so many different people, whether you're in the service industry or your customer service or anything like that. And the way that you are expected to act from your bosses as it is, you should act like that in your own business. Because if you don't give off, like, the right, like, the positive customer service, people are going to be intimidated by you. So say you go out to eat, or say you go to a bar and you have like a bartender or a server that's just totally rude to you. Like, would you want to make a conversation with them, or would you be intimidated to talk to them? Like, you wouldn't. So be that person on the other side of the counter for your business. Be like, you know, hey, how are you? What's been up to you? Like, act like you've known them for so long, even if it's the very first time that you ever met them. And, you know, I have done that for so long, being on this side or the other side of the bar, you know, serving people, whatever. I've done that, but it's just now hitting me like, oh my gosh, why am I not like that 24/7 for anyone that I run into? And, you know, like, yes, I make decent money behind the bar and, you know, whatever, but why am I not like applying that to my everyday life? Because just because, you know, I try and fulfill what my owners want from me at the place of work, why would I not hold myself accountable for, you know, my own business? Why would I not show my affection to people that I've never met? So that was just kind of my little aha moments, and I felt like I should share, because I know that a lot of you guys still have a job and you're trying to retire from it. And, you know, I'm trying to get out of the bar. I'm trying to do everything that I can, and there's no excuses. I'm at the bar right now. Okay. Yes. Granted, it is slow, but I still tuned into the training, and I told Chrissy, I was like, oh my gosh, I had a, you know, let a bartender go this morning. And, there's no end if what's or buts. Like, I set an alarm. I made sure that I got on, and I'm fully ready to commit myself the way, you know, we can all promote together and be pumped up for the team. So I don't know. That's just hearing from everything about your guys' little thing in Vegas. I was super bummed that I didn't get to go, but hearing it from everyone, it kind of just like gave me a little slap in the face, and it was just awesome. So I just thought I would share. But yeah.
Well, adding on to what she said, you guys, like, just really quick. no matter what your job is, no matter what your career would have been if you don't want to do this, you're in sales. Life is sales. That's it. I don't care if you are a cashier at Walmart. I don't care if you are a lawyer. I don't care what you do. You're in sales. So you can either be in sales for yourself and your own business and make all the money, or you can be in sales for somebody else's business and for their kids and for their family and for their vacations and for their time. So you have to decide, like, just like what she was explaining, like, you're going to be doing it anyways. So you might as well be doing it for yourself, because we're so, like, you know, in this employee mindset that we're like, they told me to be happy. They told me to show up at 9 a.m. and work really hard. So that's what I'm going to do. And then we're like, but I don't want to do that for my own business. That's going to pay me a bajillion dollars more. Like, we got to get out of that. You know, we got to get past that. Apply the way you act in your 9 to 5 into your business, and you're going to be like a millionaire in a year. Seriously, like, you have to work or you will get fired. We're such like a consequence driven generation. You know, it's like, oh, you don't pick that up, you go to your room. You do this or else I'm going to do this. But in your business, like, there's consequences. You are your own consequence, you know, for your own business. And so, you know, if you need to give yourself a consequence, like, all right, I can't have any ice cream tonight if I don't sign a distributor, because I know that would motivate me. You know, like, if that's what you need to do to start getting out of that mindset, like, do it, you know? But is there anyone else that wants to say something? Or Eliana, I see you unmuted.
I do want to say a few things, guys. So I have a few things here that stood out. Basically, this goes for the people that, you know, they feel some kind of pain for some whatever thing. I mean, we all have a story. We all have a pain. We all have something. And those emotions paralyze you guys. So give me 1 second over here. Okay. So it says right here, stop feeling sorry for yourself. Embrace it. Pain, go through with it, because you can't go under it, you can't go over it, and you can't go underneath it, you can't go any other way but through it. You know what I mean? So just don't, whatever pain you're feeling and whatever sorry you're feeling for yourself, guys, honestly, go through with it. Just whatever it is, go through with it, because that's what's making you and holding you back from where you need to be. And comparing yourself, obviously we say this a million times, but honestly, guys, when you compare yourself, it equals to unproductiveness, it equals to jealousy and unhappiness. And that gets you nowhere, guys. When you are feeling stuck, when you're in a funk, when you are like, oh, I can't get out of this, it's because there is no motion. You need to start moving, get busy, make a post, contact someone, call a friend, watch a video. There is the millions of things you could do. But the last thing you need to do is sit down and feel sorry for yourself, because stressing out and feeling that way is not going to get you anywhere, guys. It takes you to get incredibly like obsessed with what you do. And honestly, don't go like a day without wasting. Okay, don't waste a day. Don't go, you know, wasting a week or whatever, even a month. Don't take breaks, guys. Stop hitting the brakes on yourself. You know, like, you're so pumped, you're ready to go, boom, boom. And then you're like, I don't know if I'm going to do this, you know, and then stop hitting brakes. And there goes that microwave thing too. It's because a popcorn needs 2 full minutes to be, you know, obviously all popped up and ready. But if you keep opening it, there's never going to be a 2 full minutes, you know, and it won't ever be there. And that goes into another quote that I love. They said, people want crockpot results with microwave efforts. I mean, that stood out to me so much. Like, how do you expect to have like this amazing dinner with a microwave, like with a microwave effort? You know what I mean? Stop doing that, guys. And then another thing, when people feel unmotivated, like a lot of my girls contact me, you guys know who you are. I feel unmotivated. I feel this, I feel that. Guess what, guys? There's a quote right here, and I'm always going to repeat it to you every time you call me. It says, people who are not able to motivate themselves must be content with mediocrity. So you got to motivate yourself, girl. If you are, you know, not content with where you are in life, that is enough motivation to get up and do what you got to do. That's all. That's literally it, guys.
That's literally it. That's all she wants to say. I actually wrote that down on my notes too, to share, because that's so true. Like, we can feel sorry for ourselves, like, but you know what? I can also give you 10 people that have a way worse circumstance in life than you, that are working hard and, you know, hitting the top. That's like what it is, you know? And guess what? Like, as hard as life hits us sometimes, and, you know, nobody knows what anyone else is going through. Like, as hard as life hits us, no one is going to pay you for it. No one is going to pay you for, you know, feeling sorry for yourself or these excuses or whatever it might be. you know? So like Eliana said, you can't go anywhere except for through it. So go through it full force. And you know what? Like, I know people that they turn that pain into motivation because they're, you know, their business makes them happy and it's almost like a nice distraction. So they just go full force, you know? But yeah, so is there anyone else that wants to say anything? Also,
you can't deposit excuses, guys. You can only deposit cash.
Yeah. There was a guy too. He talked about, you know, the fact that he rebuilt his business 4 times. One of them because his upline was like, I'm going to another company and you can come with me or you can come or not. And, you know, it's just so funny because he's like, I rebuilt 4 times and guess what? Like, it doesn't matter. Like, cause it's the journey. And you're still going to be here in 10 years and you're still going to be having an amazing life, an amazing income, an amazing time doing it. So, you know, it doesn't matter. You just keep going. Like, that's it. You just keep going. And there's like 2 videos where a guy talked about like actual messages and things that you can send out to people to get them in front of you. I'll post that video. I don't want to like talk about those right now because, I'd have to wait for everyone to write it out and stuff. So I'll post those. But yeah, is there anyone else that wants to say anything or share?
Nope. The Rocky story. You remember the Rocky story?
Do you want to share it?
Yeah, I actually heard that one before because I like to obviously listen to Anthony Robbins, if you guys don't know. But every day. So basically when I feel down, I put him on. So when I feel unmotivated, I put him on. But he mentioned that story before, and they mentioned that in the GoPro convention, how he saw the movie Rocky, he saw the fighter in real life, and that motivated him to write a story about the movie. And so he did, and then because he wanted to be, before that, I jump from one point A to B and then C. But anyways, how he wanted to be an actor and he wrote this movie and these people, they wanted to buy it. And he's like, but you gotta put me in it. And they're like, no, we're not gonna put you in it. And he's like, well, then I'm not gonna sell it to you. And they're like, okay, so they put the price higher. And then he's like, am I gonna be in it? And then, because he knew what he wanted, so he was like, not gonna take that for no, you know. So he kept going. He's like, where am I gonna be in it? He's like, no, but we're gonna pay you more. And then, and before that too, he got in a fight with his wife because he wanted to be an actor and that's all he focused on, because he's just like, this is what I want to do. So if I have to risk, you know, my marriage, then I will. He sold his dog. And then finally they told him, okay, we're going to give you this much. Okay, you can be part of it. And then he's like, and then he was, and then he made like good money on that movie and he got his dog back. And the person that he sold the dog to, I don't know if I'm missing anything about the story, but if the person he sold the dog to, he was part of that movie too. But the moral of the story was that he, like, it's crazy. Like, he knew what he wants and he knew what he wanted it. And he just kept focusing and focusing and focusing. He went through a lot of stuff. Like, he went through a lot. I think he was living in the car once and like all these things, but at the end of the day, he got what he wanted, but it took him a while for that.
Yeah. And they said like, you know what, we're going to pay you just a little bit if you want to be in the movie. And he said, okay, you know, you're taking a risk with me and I'm taking a risk with you, you know? And so like, but you know, the biggest thing with that story is like, you have to know your end result, because as long as you know your end result, and nothing and nobody will stop you from it. It doesn't matter who says no. It doesn't matter what happens. You just have this end result. And it's like, you're not looking left at other people. You're not looking right, you know, at the people that don't want it. You're just going through everybody until somebody says yes. You know, like one of the guys said that entrepreneurs are, well, network marketers are sorters. We are not, you know, motivators. We're not like, oh, sign up, sign up, sign up. You know, we are sorters. We sort through people that don't want it to to find someone that does. Okay, we sort through more people. Like, you're not like, oh my gosh, like this five people told me no. Like, you're just sorting through people and finding the people that actually do want it. Like, that's all it takes, you know? But thank you guys so much for being on. I know it's been like forever, but I appreciate you guys all staying on, and I will get this up as soon as possible, and I will also post that other video with some of the things that the guy said. You know, you can message somebody, but take away to, you know, take them offline and get them in person to make that connection if you can. Ian, I love you all, and happy Monday. Okay, bye.